Hey there, it's Kaylee. In this lesson, we will learn how to classify and identify the parts of solid figures. So far, we have learned about two-dimensional shapes, like triangles and parallelograms. We call these types of shapes plane figures, because they lie in one plane and have no depth. In this lesson, we will work with three-dimensional shapes. We also call these shapes solid figures, because they do have depth. We're going to learn how to name these 3D shapes and their parts. The first solid figure we are going to talk about is a prism. A prism is a figure that has two parallel, congruent bases and flat sides. The bases can be any polygon. One example of a prism you probably know is a cube. You can see the top and the bottom of the cube are parallel and congruent squares. But since a prism can have bases of any polygon, we can also have triangular prisms like this one. See how both faces are parallel and congruent triangles? What shape do you see on the sides? Yes, those ones are rectangles. We also have solid figures called cylinders. Cylinders have bases that are circles. A rectangle is wrapped around the edges of the bases to form the center. Can you think of a time in your life you've seen a cylinder? Yeah, like a soup can. Those are cylinders. Next, we have pyramids. Pyramids have a polygon base and triangle sides that meet at a point. Here we have a hexagonal pyramid. So the base is a six-sided polygon, and the sides are all triangles that meet at a point. But when you hear the word pyramid, you might think about the Egyptian pyramids. Those are square pyramids. So instead of a six-sided base, they have a four-sided base. Now we have a cone. A cone is a circular base, and its sides are smooth and meet at one point. Notice that the sides of a cone are made up of one piece, like a cylinder. What does this shape remind you of? Maybe like eating an ice cream cone? The last solid figure we're going to talk about is the sphere. A sphere is a collection of points that are the same distance to a center point that forms a circular shape. You're probably familiar with spheres if you've ever kicked a soccer ball or dribbled a basketball. Those balls are spheres. Now we're going to learn about the parts of solid figure: face, edge, and vertex. The face on a solid figure is any flat surface. A solid figure can have more than one, like this pentagonal prism. It has five sides and two bases, so altogether, seven faces. But this sphere has no flat surfaces, so it has zero faces. An edge is the line segment where two faces meet. Notice where the base of this prism meets the face is a line. That is what the edge is. This triangular prism has nine edges. But look at this cone. It only has one face, the circular base. But since it only has one face, there are zero edges. A vertex is where the end of an edge meets the end of another edge and forms a corner. On this cube, we can see where the edges meet to form the corners. A cube has eight vertices. Since this cylinder has no edges that meet at a point, it has zero vertices. Nice work! You've classified the parts and the types of solid figures. You can practice what you've learned by doing the online games and quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.